I take this opportunity to thank the organizers for giving me this opportunity to speak and share the HSC best practices which we feel are worth sharing. I'm also thankful to my organization, GAIL India Limited, for having brought me here, especially the director of projects who has led from the front and he's here along with the team. So my presentation will briefly cover the few slides about GAIL activities, what we do, what is GAIL, and then I come over to the HSC policy and what are the best practices in GAIL India Limited. Do I change your slide? Okay. GAIL India Limited is the state-owned company. This was formed on 16th August 1984. We have a vision to be the leading company in natural gas and beyond, with global focus, committed to the customer care, value creation for all stakeholders, and environmental responsibility. We have a mission to accelerate and optimize the effective and economic use of natural gas and its fractions to the benefit of the national economy. This is a brief journey of three decades of growth of GAIL. We started in 1984, and the first cross-country pipeline, HVJ pipeline, Hajra-Vijaypur Jagdishpur, was laid. Thereafter, we entered into LPG and CGD business. We were given Navratna status, given to the few organizations who excel in their area. And then we entered into petrochemicals, followed by LNG import. First, spot LNG at the Dahej terminal, brought in 2006. We formed various JVs, and one of the JVs was the Brahmaputra Cracker and Petrochemicals Limited. Then we have a petrochemical plant at Pata, which was expanded to 410 KTA capacity. And then we formed a wholly owned GAIL Gas India Limited for doing the CGD business. Thereafter, year after year, we have been laying various cross-country pipelines. And we did the LNG deals with the US and Russia. We acquired shale gas assets in USA. And thereafter, we Government of India gave us next level Maharatna status, which is given to some of the very few prestigious organizations. We have total network about 11,000 kilometers of natural gas pipelines, which has the carrying capacity of 206 MMSCMD of gas, LPG, 2,050 kilometers, combined capacity of 3.8 MMTPA. We have gas sourcing, trading, long-term import portfolio, about 24 million metric tons per annum. Out of that, 13.23 is from LNG sea route and 10.6 from cross-border pipeline. We have a large business in petrochemical. It's about 810 KTA at Pata, and combined the petrochemical capacity is more than 1 million tons per annum. LPG, as I mentioned, we have 6 process plants, capacity of 1.3 million metric tons per annum. I'm just rushing through because some of the important points. We are also having presence in the upstream. We have 11 domestic blocks, 2 at Myanmar and 1 shale gas asset in USA. We have overseas presence in US, Singapore, Myanmar, China, Egypt. And City Gas, we have subsidiary, as I mentioned, GAIL Gas Limited, plus 9 joint venture companies, and we are serving 23 cities in the country. We also have diversified our portfolio in wind and solar energy. As a result of all these activities, we have presence in 16 states of the country. We operate every third out of 4 total natural gas transmission pipeline. That means 3/4 of the total capacity is handled by us. We contribute 2/3 of natural gas sold in India. We are responsible for 1/4 of India's total LPG transmission. And every 1/5 of polythene produced is done by us. We operate more than 2/3 of India's total CNG stations. And every LPG cylinder, 1/13, is by us. Look at our operations. We are operating through the pan-India presence we have. We have National Gas Management Center at Noida, through which where we monitor the real-time data of all the pipeline parameters, supply and delivery conditions. And there are 10 regional gas management centers spread all over the India. We also have instant leak detection with the help of remote terminal units, and SCADA is helping us in all these activities. Look at some of the hazards associated with our operation maintenance. Being the hydrocarbon company, most of us know that how hazardous are the natural gas and LPG. Handling of liquid hydrocarbons and gas processing plants in petrochemicals, they pose a lot of significant risks to human environment. So the provision of protective measures are essential for safe operation and maintenance. All the pipeline networks, GPUs, petrochemicals, they have established and documented integrated management system following national integration codes and standards like ASME, API, OISD, NFPA, PNGRB, etc. Gentlemen, coming to the corporate HSC policy, which is a driving document for implementation of HSC management system across the company. It is duly signed by Chairman and Managing Director. And few salient features are it stresses on the organization culture of HSC excellence. It talks about going beyond the statutes. It talks about various occupational hygiene measures, minimizing emissions and discharge environment, and continuous structured training to the employees and best practices. Based on the Oil Industry Safety Directorate, which is a technical arm of Ministry of Petroleum and Natural Gas in India, we have designed our HSC management system, which consists of 18 elements. The top element is, of course, leadership and commitment, and it ends with the compliance audit. I will not go into the details because of paucity of time, but I'll pick up some of the very important areas wherein we dwell more. Since last couple of years, our approach to HSC management has been more focused on the leadership and commitment, development of safety culture, development of standardization, IT-enabled processes, training and awareness, rigorous safety audits, performance measurement tools. So I'll dwell upon each of them. Leadership and commitment. There are two levels of leadership and commitment, I would say. One is the board level, which is the corporate management. Here, the executive, the exclusive Sustainable Development Subcommittee of board oversees all the HSE matters at the GAIL corporate level. And every month, we have the exceptions of HSE are brought, and they are discussed, reviewed by the directors, director projects, and director HR in our company, though are the technical directors. And as far as the visible and fat leadership is concerned, the very fact that our director projects is attending this program along with the team, that shows involvement in the HSC issues. Then at the site level, safety leadership, if you talk about every site, the in charge of every site, he observes, he devotes at least 4 hours a day on 10th of every day, every month, when we observe the monthly safety day. This is compulsory, wherein all the issues related to HSE are reviewed, discussed in detail, and then a report is submitted to corporate departments, which is further reviewed by the directors, as I mentioned already. Gentlemen, we analyze some of the incident data produced by the Oil Industry Safety Directorate, as I mentioned, is a technical arm of Ministry of Petroleum and Natural Gas. As can be seen, out of various regions of incidents, which they analyzed, incidents picking up for last 11 years, the more than 58% of incidents took place due to human error. So this is an area which is very, very important. These incidents could have been averted by reinforcing positive behavior. So again, if you want to go develop a good safety culture, then these behavioral issues need to be addressed, which is already can be seen from the incidents analysis. So we brought in behavior-based safety intervention in our company in 2013, and we have took it to all the nooks and corners, each and every installation. We organized various safety training on behavior-based safety one day, which is given to all employees and contract workers as well. And we formed certain lead trainers who can take it further to each and every person, and then how to observe the safe behavior, how to observe the unsafe behavior, how to counsel the employees. They were trained in it. And then we developed a centralized portal through which we keep getting the reports from the sites, and we analyze on a monthly basis where to give more focus. We also organize BBS promotional events at sites, events like friendly matches and cricket matches, a marathon in the name of BBS, so that the concept goes to hearts of the people. And in fact, we are trying to touch upon the schools and the ladies also, because of the job safety is equally important. When we want to bring the difference in your behavior, then it will be reflected in your work as well at your home. Some of the pictures you are seeing displayed at our sites. Standard operating procedure. This is one of the very, very important area which needs to be more focused. So what we did, these are all written by our own people, but then we got them reviewed by international reputed agencies like British Safety Council for all the process plants, and for all the pipelines we brought in DNVGL. And all the SOPs we have standardized. We have also developed a film on the critical SOPs of each plant. These are the animated films. I'll show you one small film. One of the animated standard operating film.
GAIL India Limited. Standard operating procedure for changeover of RG compressor B to A. Inform the control room that running RG compressor B is being changed over to RG compressor A. Check the lube oil level, minimum 70%. Start the auxiliary lube oil pump of RG compressor A and run for at least 10 minutes before starting the compressor to ensure that adequate lube oil is flowing to the piston chamber of the compressor. Start the cooling water pump and ensure that sufficient water is flowing through the jacket of the RG compressor A. Open suction and discharge valve of compressor A. Start RG compressor A and run it in unload mode for 10 minutes and observe for any abnormality. Set the load on compressor A at 25%. Check the current drawn by the compressor A. It should be around 48 ampere. Load RG compressor A to 50%, 75%, and at last 100% mode. At the same time, reduce the...
So I'll just stop it in between because of the paucity of time. That is how all these steps are listed out for all the critical action, and the operator is shown this film so that there's no chance of him forgetting. He can see it again and again, and he can avoid any critical error which could happen. We have also created various books and standards, our internal standards for guidelines related to operation maintenance and fire safety policy, various equipment specifications. And we have developed a robust incident reporting system, which the highlight is that we have multiple SMS and voice telephony system. Nobody can miss the message. Then we have started leveraging IT in the safety management system. The SAP enhancement has been done so that through the workflow-based system, an incident is recorded, and till the time all the investigation issues which are pointed out are complied, it remains in the focus by individuals. Risk assessment, management of change, another very important area. Any significant change in the process or the hardware must be recorded and must go through a process management change. And a unique number generated through the SAP, so you can always refer it back what steps were taken correctly or not. Training and awareness, we have a dedicated GAIL Training Institute at Noida, wherein we train all our employees on various aspects. Then live firefighting training, we have developed facilities at our process plants. These are some of the facilities where we do the simulation through process column fire, flange fire, blaze, boiling liquid expanding vapor explosion, then various live firefighting training. It's given to the security forces as well as the ladies and children as well. We carry out the mock drills, again to rehearse, and we have brought in radio jingle for sensitizing the community on pipeline safety. We have brought in a GAIL Sahyogi scheme to engage the villagers for pipeline surveillance. We carry out Nukkad Nataks. These are the spot plays related to safety, so sensitize the community on public safety. We have a robust safety audit system, and annually each site has to undergo external safety audit, and all the points are to be liquidated in a time-bound manner. Then the last but not the least, the HSE performance measurement tools are very important, because if you can't measure it, you can't improve it. So we have a HSE score system through which every month the performance of each site is measured, HSE performance. And the best HSE performance site is rewarded with the CMD trophy end of the year. These are few initiatives in environment management, biodiversity, birthday gardens, global methane initiative along with the US EPA agency. This is a study carried out of our sites, flora and fauna. As an impact of the latest initiatives we took last 3 years, we have achieved zero incident in 2016 and 17 across the company. I consider it as one of the major achievements. And we went back to one of the consultants to benchmark us in all the HSE KPIs, compare it with the best of the companies in the world. And this is the slide wherein we are happy to share that in most of the parameters, like number of incidents in NG pipeline at each 10,000 kilometers, we are near to median. Number of incidents in LPG pipeline, we are better than many. I mean, in fact, we are more than median level. Number of incidents in process plants, 0.3 incidents per million man hours, which is very close to the best. And similar way, the fatalities are zero, LTIFR 0.2, severity rate of incidents 3, illness cases 0.17, which is almost median. No, 0.17 is the median. In fact, we are almost close to zero. Number of environmental accident release, we are at the median. Number of environmental accident release in LPG, we are almost close to the best. And regulatory permit accidents in the process plants per year, we are near to median. These are some of the awards and accolades we received from the Minister of Petroleum and Natural Gas, Government of India. Our chairman and directors receiving that. With continuous focus on HSE across our installations, GAIL has won many awards as like Oil Industry Safety Directorate, British Safety Council UK, Institution of Directors. To conclude, I would say out of various good practices, I would list out 8 best practices as I already given in my presentation. Visible safety leadership at top level and the local level. Observance on monthly safety day on 10th of every month. Reinforcement of positive behavior at work. Animated films on the critical SOPs. Leveraging IT in safety management. Community engagement in safety promotional activities. Measurement of HSE performance through HSE score system on monthly basis, and benchmarking of HSE KPI. In the end, as my director told me, that why can't we also say health, safety, environment? In fact, we can also call HSE as healthy and safe employee for an employer. Thank you very much.